Good afternoon, everyone. Honorable Director, sir, respected Principal, ma'am, my colleagues, teachers, dear parents, and our stipends. I, Mrs. Vaidehi Pandey, would like to welcome you all for PT1 induction program today. PT1 is periodic test 1. On assessment, we measure what we value instead of valuing only what we can measure. Assessment is an integral part, though it's not the only way to know our child. This pandemic situation is helping us to learn new techniques. Last year, we also had assessment scheduled, or we conducted exams in a different way. I mean, by using virtual platform and some different techniques. Whenever we perform or we do, we understand the process better. This time also, we have tried to use a different technique for this assessment. And to understand this technique in a better way, we have invited you all. This technique we actually have used for grade 9 and 10 already for their first assessment in the month of May. And we found out that this is the better technique than the previous one. So because we have already tested this technique and we actually have gone through it, we thought that we should implement this technique with you all, with our children in this academic year. And we are going to see how this technique is useful and how it is efficient for our students and for us as well. So this time we are coming up with different assessment technique. And to understand this technique, let me call Sunetra ma'am to take it over ahead. Sunetra ma'am, over to you.
Thank you, Vaidehi ma'am. Good afternoon to one and all present here. Respected Principal ma'am, Honorable Director sir, staff members, teachers, and my dear children. I, Mrs. Sunetra Rajamohinde, would like to welcome you all on behalf of the Stepping Stone School for the PT1 assessment induction. Coming together is a beginning. Keeping together is progress. And working together is success. With this beautiful quote, I shall begin with the guidelines of PT1 assessment for the academic year 2021-22. Parent plus teacher is equal to educated child. No school can work well for the children if parents and teachers not act in partnership on behalf of the child's best interests. At the end of the day, the most overwhelming key to a child's success is the positive involvement of parents as well as the teachers. So dear parents, this is the PT1 date sheet wherein the assessment begins from 19th of July and ends by 23rd of July. We will be sharing the PDF of this induction once the induction gets over for your reference. Next slide, please. Dear parents, kindly note that grade 1 and grade 2 shall have a holiday on 23rd of July, whereas grade 3 to grade 8 shall be having their social studies paper. On 24th July, we will be starting with our regular sessions and we have to follow the timetable for Saturday. PT1 assessment shall be of 10 marks. The syllabus for PT1 assessment is already being shared in the grade group. The exam timings for grade 1, grade 2, grade 4 and grade 7 shall begin by 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. Grade 3, grade 5 and grade 6 shall begin by 9:30 a.m. to 10:30 a.m. Begin by 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. The duration of the assessment shall be 1 hour. 1 hour includes 10 minutes for the segregation of the children in the breakout rooms, reading time and settling time. 40 minutes will be counted for the writing time, as well as 10 minutes will be allotted for revision and extra time. Online meet invite shall be shared through TSSS licensed ID for all the three assessment slots. So dear parents, we will be having three slots, and the meet invite shall be shared by the licensed ID of the Stepping Stone School. Breakout rooms will be created for the assessment. So as soon as the child enters the main room, the children will be segregated in their breakout rooms. Each breakout room will have 7 to 8 students of same grade and 2 teachers. So 2 teachers will be invigilating there in the breakout room, and nearly we will have 7 to 8 students in one breakout room of same grade. The subject teacher shall be visiting each breakout room to solve the doubts of the students. So in each breakout room, as there will be 2 invigilators, also the subject teacher is going to visit and clear the doubts whatever the children have. The subject question paper will be shared on the screen in each breakout room. The link of the question will be shared with the student, unlike the previous assessment. So in the previous assessments, dear parents, we would actually share the PDF as well as the link to the children in the chat box. But this time, do take care, we are not going to share the link in the chat box. But yes, if any connectivity issue persists from the side or by the end of the child, you are surely going to connect the helpline numbers, wherein we will be showcasing at the end of the image. Students are expected to adjust the focus of their cameras in a way that the table and the students both are clearly visible to the teachers. So during the assessment, when the children are writing the papers, the camera should be in such a way that it should focus the child as the table.
So we have already started the class tests in all the classes with all the subjects, and students have already been told what all details have to be mentioned on the top margin of the notebook. Similar format will be followed where the students are attempting the assessments. The page number starting from 1 for each subject shall be mentioned at the bottom of each page, enclosed in a circle. Every page that has been used shall be numbered properly. For every subject, page number will start with number 1 and it should be enclosed in a circle. Now on the next slide, let's see a sample page that could be used as a reference. So parents, you can see there is a format on the top margin of the page. On the left side, you can see the top margin, how the format has to be mentioned. And on the right side, you can see how the page numbers are to be mentioned. So as suggested by Sunetra ma'am, this format should be ready beforehand in order to save time so that the child can focus on writing the assessments. Now, let's talk about the submissions. Students are expected to share the answer sheets within the given time limit. Grade 1 and 2, 30 minutes after the assessments. Grade 3 to 5, 20 minutes after the assessment. And grade 6 to 8, 10 minutes after the assessment. Now, as ma'am, Sunetra ma'am has already told that the students will be given ample amount of time during the session itself to complete their assessment. That is why the time has been reduced for the submissions. Grade 1 and 2 will be submitting within the 30 minutes after the assessment session ends. Grade 3 to 5, 20 minutes. And grade 6 to 8 will submit the answer sheets within 10 minutes. If a student misses to share the answer sheets within the above mentioned time, that answer sheet will be categorized under late submission, applicable for the deduction of marks accordingly. So parents, please take a note to abide by the timings in order to avoid such situation of deducting of marks. Ample practice per grade shall be done through class tests to get children accustomed to the entire process. All the classes have already started with the class tests, and the process will be slowly by slowly explained to all the students, and they will be given ample amount of practice in the upcoming week so that they know what is the process. The answer sheet of each subject shall be photographed and a cumulative PDF shall be generated. The method of converting a group of pictures to a PDF is already uploaded on our school's YouTube channel, The Stepping Stone News. So parents, this process is something which we have been doing for a long time now. All the pages used for the answers will be clicked properly, and a cumulative PDF will be sent to the grade email IDs. The video on how to convert the pictures into PDF is shared on the YouTube channel, our school's YouTube channel, The Stepping Stone News. Also, the same link will be shared with you just after the presentation. The PDF of the subject's answer sheet shall be shared on the grade mail ID and the subject teacher's mail ID after each assessment. The mail IDs will be shared a day prior along with the Zoom invite. So the PDF of the subject answer sheet will be shared on the grade email IDs and the subject teacher's mail IDs, which will be shared along with the invite. Next point. Parents, this is an important point. No answer sheets to be shared in the school's mailbox. The simple reason being that there are a lot of mails received on the school mail ID. So the answer sheets may get missed. That is why we request you not to share the answer sheets on school mailbox. We expect our parents to support us by keeping a consistent check on children during the assessment. Now, after this, watching this PPT, I hope you have a lot of questions in your mind. Let's try to answer them one by one. What if my child is disconnected during the assessment session? So this has happened during the sessions also. The child might get disconnected during the session. So we request you to keep trying. Find a suitable place in your house where there is a stable connection. Also, if the problem persists, please call the helpline number. Now, second point is, in case of network issue, how shall my child mail the answer sheets? So in case of network issue, usually the mail is in your outbox folder of your email account. So you can keep checking your outbox folder till the network is stable. Once stable network, the mail goes from outbox to send. That means your mail is already sent. Also, in the case of network issue, you can inform the teacher that there is an issue and you cannot send the mail. We both are working parents. Will there be any change in submission for us? So parents, if you both are working, you can tell your children to click the pictures of their answer sheets, send it to you at your working place through WhatsApp. Now, when you have received all the images, you can create a proper PDF and mail it to us within the time. So there is no change in the time for submissions, but yes, you can ease out by following this step. This has been done by various parents in the previous exams also. My child is very young to understand this new method. What am I going to do? So if your child is very young, we have already started the class tests, and we are going to inform the students step by step what has to be done, what steps have to be followed in order to understand the process. And I'm sure that all the students will be well aware of the process before the PT1 assessment starts. As I mentioned in the previous slides, that you can call the helpline numbers. So these are the helpline numbers, the contact numbers of Mrs. Anushka Palande, Mrs. Saili Abhyankar, and Mrs. Vaidehi Pandey, our school coordinator. You can note down these numbers also. These will be shared to you after the induction program so that you have them in your record. You can call these in the helpline numbers in case of any network issue, any problem you're facing during the PT1 assessments. Luck is for the lazy. Success is for those who work hard. So parents, we are trying to make children comfortable as if they are attending the exams physically. All the parents are requested to cooperate in order to inculcate discipline in our children. With this, we have come to an end to our PPT presentation. As mentioned by Sunetra ma'am, now we'll be having the demo for how to place your camera and the child's notebook during the PT1 assessment. So as you can see, the child, his table, his notebook, everything is visible. This is how the camera should be placed. So that the invigilator can see the child as well as his notebook.
Parents, you have seen how the child is sitting, writing his paper. Please understand the child needs to be on unmute when the paper will start. Because this question will arise, how will the child talk to the teacher, clarify his or her doubt if the child is sitting way at a distance or way far from the camera, so that the child doesn't have to come up and keep muting and unmuting themselves.
Thank you so much, ma'am. So, I hope parents, the setup is clear to you. And now let's open the forum for parents. If you have some doubts, please ask so that we can clarify your doubts.
Harsha Rapte.
Yes, Mr. Rapte.
Regarding keeping the students on unmute, because maybe there would be a possibility that there could be a chaos while solving the paper itself, because kids at this age keep on asking questions and doing that kind of thing. So how to handle those?
May I take this question? Yeah, thank you. Good afternoon, Mr. Apte. So see, the point is the system is as new to us as it is to you. Though we have had a pilot project run during grade 9 and 10 exams in the month of May, we need to again understand if the child is asking a question, those kind of questions and the practice of asking the question will be done during the test papers, when the class tests are happening, which exactly are going on right now, and will also happen extensively and intensively for the next week too. So we will make sure that somehow a rule or a kind of agreement is set up between the child and the teacher that during the exam time, whenever they have to ask, they can raise their hand over there, as the number of children are very less in the breakout room and there are two teachers on 7 or 8 children. It is easy to see. So even when the child raises his or her hand and not speak, the teacher will be able to control the environment and the practice and your presence, your support, I think we'll be able to manage it. Hope I have answered your question, Mr. Apte. Thank you so much. Mr. Jaiswal had a question whether the child is able to see. So parents, the complete screen right now, which is visible to you, think of it will be the paper. It will be magnified. We will not have a complete paper in one go. We will have some part of the question looking at the level, the grade of the child. We'll have only two questions or one question displayed. So it will be completely possible for the child to gauge what the child is watching. Hello. Please, thank you so much, Mr. More. Yes.
Sorry, I actually, maybe I missed the one point if somebody asked, but let me ask you. Both we are working, myself and my wife is working, and one of your from your point, our child has to send us the WhatsApp pictures, but maybe that time my wife or myself will be busy. So what will be the timing, what will the duration of time to send us that pictures to the concerned mail ID?
Mr. More, If there are certain parents who are working and there is no one at home, the child could send the pictures of his or her paper to you when you are in the office. Just take a little bit of time out to make it in the PDF and send it back to the child, looking at the 30, 20 and 10 ratio of the duration for the different grades. It'll be easier for you to send the answer sheets back if at all there's still any kind of issue that arises. We can entertain a call from a parent a day before saying, this is the issue, how can we resolve it in a better manner? And my teachers will be there to find a solution to it. Is it okay, Mr. More?
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely.
Thank you. Technical errors are something which we accept, but it should not be taken undue advantage.
Exactly.
Right, that is the only thing, because somehow we want our children to get the discipline.
Exactly.
Yes, we just want to get them back in the same feeling that, yes, it's an exam going on, it's a school, and my teacher is there with me. That is the only thing that we are trying to achieve through having a new methodology for the assessment.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Mr. Modi.
Thank you.
Yes, Mrs. Gadre, please go ahead.
Ma'am, one question. The single line notebook, which has to be absolutely new for the PT1, has it to be used by the one provided from the school, or can they use any notebook purchased from outside?
Thank you so much for this question, ma'am. So please get a new single line notebook from the market, especially for the exam purpose. I'm telling you, there's one more beautiful thing that we are doing. You will be asked to submit this notebook after all the exams are done. And this time, the child's notebook will be physically checked by the teacher. So that when the notebook comes back to you, you'll be able to understand where the child has to improve and what the child has done beautifully. We will be requesting you after the exams, all the exams are over. From 24th, we'll start this process. 24th July, we'll be asking you to submit your notebooks. Yes, we'll be again giving a schedule so that we don't have a rush in the office. So we'll be asking you to submit the notebook of the child, and that is the reason we are using one separate notebook, which could be used for half release and later on other exams too. Mr. Deshpande is writing same notebook for maths. Yes, sir. Yes, Mr. Deemure. Radhika's parent, if I can ask.
Yes. Good afternoon, ma'am. So we have a doubt that...
Please go ahead.
So for all subject, only one single line notebook to be used, or for each subject, separate notebook to be used?
Yes, sir. No. Single line notebook, one single line notebook for all the subjects together.
Okay.
Page numbers will keep on starting from one. So when the child is writing English answers, if at all the child has written the answers in two pages, it'll be one and two. And when the third page will be open to write Hindi answers, the first page of Hindi answers will be page number one again.
Yes, Mrs. Neme.
Ma'am, just one question. This is regarding the format. The first page of each of the answer sheet will have that grid wherein they write their name, the subject, etc. So does that grid need to be repeated across all the answer sheet, or should it be on the first page of each new answer sheet that they are starting? I just want to know that. Thanks.
Yeah.
May I take this?
Yes, please, sir. Go ahead.
Yes, thank you so much. Good afternoon, Mrs. Nene. Thank you for this question. Yes, ma'am, the format has to be followed on this every page of every subject. A small reason for having this is you will be clicking pictures from your mobile phone, right? आपके पास हर सब्जेक्ट के हर पेज का फोटो है, फिर आपको भी वो कन्फ्यूजन नहीं होना चाहिए कि ये वाला पेज लिया कि नहीं, वो वाला लिया कि नहीं, ठीक है? So it will be easy for you to select the pictures when it is mentioned on the above margin key. Yes, this is English. This is English page 1, this is English page 2, this is English page 3. So it will be easy for you to create a PDF while you are creating it.
Okay.
Right.
So the grid and the page number both need to be present on the answer, right?
Yes. Okay. And right. Yes, with all the details.
Yeah. Okay, ma'am.
I can give a tip over there to the parents. If anybody has a computer or maybe when whosoever is working in the office, if you can just, you know, take a small slip from your paper, like, you know, on the computer or somewhere, if you can print out lots of slips, you can just stick those slips and the child could write down the, you know, the names and everything there in the second box. Or you can create your own child's name slips of such sort, and they can be used everywhere, you know, for half release, finals, PT2, everywhere we can use the same slips. Just the total number of pages will be left blank, right? And if you want, then we can also provide such kind of format to you, and then you can go ahead and take prints.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
हेलो
यस मिस्टर मोरे
मुझे थोड़ा सा कंफ्यूजन था ये जो फॉर्मेट हम लेफ्ट पेपर पे लिखने वाले उसके नीचे ही आंसर लिखना है या नेक्स्ट पेपर पे लिखना है आई एम लिटिल बिट कंफ्यूज्ड अबाउट इट
या या एम आई ऑडिबल
यस यस मैम
यस सर द फॉर्मेट हैज टू बी प्रेजेंट ऑन एवरी पेज ठीक है बच्चा नोटबुक के जितने भी पेजेस यूज करेगा उस हर पेज पे ये फॉर्मेट टॉप मार्जिन पे होना चाहिए नॉट जस्ट ऑन द लेफ्ट पेज ऑन एवरी पेज एंड ऑन एवरी पेज देयर मस्ट बी अ पेज नंबर राइट ताकि टीचर को भी समझ में आए आपने ऊपर लिखा है टोटल नंबर ऑफ टोटल पेजेस यूज 3 बट पीडीएफ में 2 ही पेज आए हैं तो एटलीस्ट टीचर आपको रिमाइंड करा सकती है ना कि सर एक पेज नहीं आया आप उसको भेज दीजिए है ना जस्ट टू क्रॉस चेक कि कुछ मिस ना हो जाए ये चीज़ पुट अप की गई है कि आपको ऊपर भी मेंशन करना और नीचे पेज नंबर भी मेंशन करना एंड फॉर्मेट हैज टू बी प्रेजेंट ऑन एवरी पेज एंड बिकॉज इट्स अ टाइम टेकिंग प्रोसेस दैट इज व्हाई वी हैव मेंशन्ड दैट यू हैव टू डू इट बिफोर हैंड
या थैंक यू मैम गॉट इट Thank you.
Mrs. Ingle, please go ahead with your question.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, good afternoon, ma'am. Tell me.
Good afternoon. अगर हम इतने डिस्टेंस पे रखेंगे मोबाइल होगा मतलब जो सिटिंग अरेंजमेंट्स आपने बताई है तो विजिबिलिटी में प्रॉब्लम हो सकती है ना बच्चों को
मैम एक्चुअली जब हमने ग्रेड 9-10 के लिए लिया था मिसेस इंगले तब तो प्रॉब्लम नहीं आई थी बट अगर ऐसा कोई भी इशू आएगा सो बिकॉज द Teachers are there. There are 2 teachers, as I again and again I'm saying. So the teachers in smaller classes will also read the question. As the number of questions are very less and the child says, no, I'm not able to see or whatever, the teachers can read the question to them because the child is communicating, right? So I'm sure it will not create a problem. Lekin agar chahiye, aap apni taraf se ek experiment ghar mein kar sakte.
Ma'am, can I add something to this?
Yes, please, Surbhi, ma'am. Go ahead.
Even after sharing something on the screen, the person watching that screen can also magnify it by, you know, zooming in on the screen. So yeah. If a particular thing is not visible when the teacher has shared the PDF, you can zoom in to your screen so that you can see a particular question clearly.
I think with the help of the parent and the teacher, we'll be able to resolve any kind of challenge that we may face while the children are writing the paper. If one of you or any elder is present with the child, it becomes all the more easy. You can sit at a place which is near the device, right? Because we definitely do not want the parent to sit with the child. So you can sit near the device. If the child says that I cannot see, you can also magnify it like Surbhi ma'am has told.
Parents, we have already shared the syllabus in all the grades and the planner for the month of July is already shared with you all in the beginning of this month only. So please refer the July planner. All the tests on respective dates are mentioned there only. So there's no confusion related to एग्जाम कब है कौन सी डेट पे होगा एवरीथिंग इज देयर डिटेल्ड इन द प्लानर सो आई होप दैट विल हेल्प यू आउट फॉर द गेटिंग द डेट शीट आल्सो फ्रॉम द प्लानर ओनली
द ग्रेड ग्रुप प्रोफाइल पिक्चर इज आल्सो द प्लानर
ऑफ जुलाई, आप सबके ग्रेड ग्रुप की जो प्रोफाइल पिक्चर है वो प्लानर ही है जुलाई का, आप उसको देखेंगे उसमें एग्जाम दिख जाएंगे आपको. थैंक यू शिखा मैम फॉर द पॉइंट. सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर योर ऑगस्ट प्रेजेंस पेरेंट्स एज ऑलवेज, एंड थैंक यू टीचर्स फॉर टेकिंग द पॉइंट्स इन अ डिटेल्ड मैनर. टुगेदर एवरीवन अचीव्स मोर, TEAM. सो लेट्स वर्क एज अ टीम हियर. And let us make sure that whatever technique we have devised, we will see how we can look at the solution orientation and the, not the problem. Thank you so much, parents, and have a very happy weekend ahead.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Okay. So, good afternoon, one and all present here. And I, Shikha Khare, on behalf of the TSS family, extend my sincere thanks to dear parents, children, respected principal ma'am, teachers, and all the other members who are listening to us. So this was a really very interactive session. We got to learn many new things today together. We got to hear so many suggestions, queries, and hope we all managed to solve your queries. And as ma'am has rightly said, together we are there to help each other for the smooth functioning of the assessment. We are learning each year, we are learning every day. So this is a new learning added again. Let's see how it goes. And I know with your support, we are definitely going to do well during the assessment. Any challenges, we are there to help you out. The helpline numbers are already there. So parents, please don't worry. And thank you for sparing some time from your schedule.
So thank you, parents. Thank you so much. And please take care of yourself.